Hey y'all, so before we begin, I am really sorry that this is a day late. I has just been so busy yesterday that I tried to get this video over and done with. But nevertheless, it's finally here. Here we go. Here's part 3 of my top 20 favorite horror movies. Welcome back to my top 20 favorite horror movies of all time. Let's continue with number 10. Army of Darkness. Even though it's more of a comedy, I still count it as a horror movie because it still has some creepy scenes. Everything in this movie works. The characters, writing, story, fights, everything. It's a satisfying conclusion to my favorite horror trilogy of all time, and it deserves it. Ash vs. Evil Dead is awesome, but it doesn't hold a candle to the original movies. Ash Williams is easily one of my favorite protagonists of all time, and this movie, besides the second, proves why he's my favorite. I love everything about this movie. It's just so funny, creative, quotable, and action-packed. If only stores and streaming services anywhere would just get the fact that Army of Darkness is still an Evil Dead movie. It's canon, it really is. Evil Dead 2 proved it. But regardless, it's still a fun movie and it definitely deserves the 10th spot on my list. The Bride of Frankenstein. This is easily my favorite Universal classic monster movie of all time. It gets better with every rewatch. It's scary, it's creative, it's gothic, it's Bride of Frankenstein! What else needs to be said? Not only is it my favorite Universal classic monster movie, but it surpasses the original Frankenstein. I talk more about it, but I want to get this list done, so all I have to say is that this is the best Universal classic monster movie of all time. Halloween. Of course it wouldn't be Halloween without Halloween. John Carpenter is one of my favorite directors of all time, and this is easily one of his best movies. The eerie music, the amazing acting, the suspenseful story, the creepy atmosphere, and Michael freaking Myers. This is one of those movies where I actually was on the edge of my friggin' seat. I actually wanted Laurie to be okay. I haven't seen the remake yet, but I hope it's as good as the original. This pick is ironic because Halloween Kills just came out last week. This was a coincidence, I swear! But with that said, Halloween is still a great tradition for me that I look forward to watch every year. Dawn of the Dead. While Night of the Living Dead started the zombie genre, Dawn of the Dead perfected it, and it also surpassed the original. This is one of those movies where you care for the characters and you want them to be okay and make it out alive. While not the case for these guys, this film is still perfect with a great story, likable characters, fantastic writing, and insane battles. Seriously, they're fighting to stay alive in this, it's just so perfectly paced. The one thing that sucks about this movie is the fact that it's banned everywhere. I'm dead serious. This film is impossible to buy, rent, or stream anywhere. So let me get this straight. This is okay. This is okay. That's fine. That's perfectly safe. But Dawn of the Dead is just going too far. I can dig that. But with that said, good luck trying to find the original movie anywhere because the only thing you'll find is the crappy 2004 remake. This film is literally impossible to find. But, and this is a big but, and I cannot lie, I just so happen to have left the link in the description where you can actually watch the movie absolutely free without going on a Lord of the Rings quest to find the original movie on DVD. I'm actually not kidding. It's on YouTube. Just don't tell anyone! It's our little secret, faithful viewer. Actually, it's not technically a secret since some people might come across the video and figure it out. And it has over 200,000 views on here. Well, see y'all in jail. But nevertheless, Dawn of the Dead is still a great sequel as well as a zombie movie to end all zombie movies. Evil Dead 2. Army of Darkness is still a great cult movie, but it wouldn't be here without this amazing movie. Hell, it set it up at the ending. Evil Dead 2 is such a perfect balance of horror, comedy, and action. Ash may have been awesome in the first Evil Dead, but in this, he's really freaking awesome. He's insane, badass, and hilarious. This movie has everything I want in a horror movie. A lovable protagonist, some great effects, creatively designed monsters, and a hilarious ending. I kinda almost felt bad for Ash at the ending, not gonna lie. Army of Darkness may have concluded the trilogy, but Evil Dead 2 still remains my favorite out of this amazing, funny, well-written, underrated trilogy. And that's it for part 3. Tune in next week for the final part of my top 20 favorite horror movies.